I thought that was some marijuana.
So, Bryce, what was that fresh drink you were drinking earlier? Because I sure could use a sponsored ad right now.
Looking for something fresh? Really craving that great fruity taste? Go for Fresca. I almost crashed, but I got the slurp in. Not sponsored. Fresca. Try it. Oh, that's a burp. Welcome to Mario Kart 8 World Wars, everybody!
Yay! Deluxe Edition! Yay!
Oh my Fresca days. Edition.
The Fresca Edition.
The slurp actually like almost killed me.
I feel like Nintendo needs to do what Capcom did and make a cart that has sponsored ads on it.
Yes, please.
Don't they have the sponsored, like, aren't there, like, the Audi cars in here that are sponsored?
Mercedes.
Mercedes.
The Mercedes, yeah.
I'm driving one right now.
Damn.
You can dream.
You get that sort of money from YouTube? You can drive a Mercedes to hell, dude.
Hell yeah.
Well,
I guess I should become a Twitch bot then.
Well, a Twitch thought.
Funnily enough, guys. Mercedes.
I'm a Twitch thought.
Mercedes actually segues very well into my story.
Wait, does Mercedes have a Segway? Like, did they make a Segway?
Oh my
god.
They
should make a Segway. I'd buy a Mercedes Segway.
Oh no.
Anyway, Sean, let's go to story time. Let's go.
Yeah, it was story time. Yay! It's for my driving test. So I might have mentioned it already in a video. I don't think
gather
I did. Just
around the children. Gather around the fire, children. Let me tell you a story.
Ah,
Grandpa Sean.
Yeah. So for any though, no, I passed my driving test. I have a full license. Yay!
Hear the YouTube sound effect of children screaming and cheering. Everyone knows the one I'm talking about, right?
Yeah, the one from Fine Bros React.
Yeah.
I thought that was from Dan and Phil.
Yes.
Bryce, just send it to me.
You got it, I have it.
Okay, let's get on with the story, yeah.
Yeah, oh my god. We were talking about it, and then I was telling the guys how, it was, like, I got kind of marked kind of harshly. We were comparing how, like, you know, tests in Europe and America are very different. You have to just, you said, just drive around a block. For me, we have an, if you're in Cork, in Ireland, the test center you will be in is called Wilton. And Wilton is a very, very difficult place to drive in. What was really annoying about the entire test in general was that when I was learning how to drive, my instructor was like, yeah, okay, so here's like pretty much every road they can take you on around here. You know, here's all the routes. They're going to bring you on some combination of these routes, you know. I'm like, okay, cool. We go on the test. I'm like, okay, cool. This is familiar. You know, he's bringing me on this roundabout and this one here. And when we come to one of the roundabouts, he tells me to take the first exit. I'm like, okay, if he's telling me to take the exit, I know where I'm going. He has one place he can bring me, which is towards this place called CIT, Cork Institute of Technology. I'm like, okay, cool. As I'm driving along the road, he says, take the next available right. I'm like, okay. And I was like, I've never turned up here before.
Oh, no.
I was like, this road exists. And I'm going down. I was like, oh, okay, he's bringing me where I haven't gone.
Oh, no.
That's my encouraging words to you. Give it your best shot. We're all cheering for your shot.
I'll give it your best shot.
But oh, my God.
Ooh, what the
Is that a Pokemon?
Is that a Jinx?
Yes.
Exactly. But that looks like the racist Jinx, like the one that they got rid of.
Okay.
I thought it was still racist.
Now it's purple,
so,
but racist.
It's purple.
Oh, right. Yeah.
So
purple
a couple
makes
of,
it
so
all
a couple
the
of
better.
Key highlights from the thing, though, was...
So you make a right turn.
Yeah, make a right turn. I'm going around and everything's fine. And then he's like, you know...
This is fine.
This is really weird, by the way. He asked me to, like, pull in up on the left, which, by the way, we drive on left side of the road here, so you guys know.
Fucking weirdo.
Oh, right. European.
And so he let me pull up on the left, and I do that. And I'm like... And then he's like, okay, now pull off again. I'm like, oh, okay. And that was it. He just wanted me to stop and start for one point. I was like, that was kind of weird. But,
Nah, probably just to check that you can handle starting and, like...
Yeah.
Starting a car from a standstill.
Yeah, and it was also on a hill, so it was a hill start as well.
Okay, yeah, that
so
makes
we,
sense.
Yeah. So we do that, and I'm like, okay, this is fine. And then he brings me to an area to do the turn of the road, or, you know, three-point turn.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, this is fine. Like, I practiced my maneuvers, like, crazy well. And I felt really confident in them. But what was bad about it was, like, kind of like, you know, like, on this road run right now, back there, where, like, there was kind of, like, slopes onto the left and right.
Mm-hmm.
That was exactly the kind of road. So when I was doing, when
so
I turned
you did
right.
Did you test on Mute City?
Yeah. But, like, so I went to do to turn the road, so I basically turned right first, and then I was getting ready to reverse. But the thing is, at this point now, the car was like slanted down a bit because it was on a bit of a hill. And I had to give it a bit of gas while reversing. And every time I gave it a bit of gas while reversing, the car kept moving forward a bit instead of going back. And I'm just like, if this happens one more time, I'm going to hit the curb. And that's an instant fail.
Right. Which is bullshit.
So
but okay.
I got it in the end, but like I was sweating bullets, man. and I got grade 2 marked for like not being able to control the car well there, and I'm like, really? I should have gotten a few grade 1s of it first and then grade 2. But alright, whatever. He had that, and then he had so the last thing to mention was he on the way back from the test, I was coming up with some traffic lights, getting ready to slow down, and there was a Mercedes indicating to come into my lane.
It was me and in my bones.
Yeah, yes,
yeah.
Mario Kart.
And in my mind, I was just like, I'm not gonna. I didn't think to slow down to let him in because I was like, I'm doing my test. I'm just gonna drive. He can do his own thing, you know. And then like I apparently got grade 2 marked because I didn't leave him come into my lane. And I'm just like, I was more afraid of getting marked by slowing down and letting him in.
Yeah, than just focusing on you.
Yeah. So I was like, that was a bit bullshit in my opinion. If I failed because of that, I would have made a huge argument against that.
Oh, yeah.
But thankfully, I didn't. Thankfully, it was great too, but I didn't fail.
Sweet!
So there you go. That's why Mercedes led into the segue of that entire story. You only find out.
Because dry bones almost cost you your driver's license.
Cool yeah, what the story. Fuck
that was?
Cool story, bro. Tell again.
Here's the story of my driving test in the US of A. My parents had just taken theirs, because obviously we all had to get our American licenses. I was right after them. I happened to get the same person testing me that tested my parents. They liked my parents. They passed me.
Well, it pays to be English sometimes.
What do you mean sometimes? Look at the history of colonization. It's always paid to be English. And that's the motherfucking... Jesus!
Oh my
Jesus
God!
Jesus, braces.
He's got these slurps on deck. Why? Okay, the guy who just entered the room.
He looks like very high.
Looks like high Cameron.
Oh my God!
High
like trying
Cameron.
Trying to hide it with glasses.
High Cameron.
I was thinking it was like a thin Peter Griffin.
Are you
That's
calling
just
Cameron
what
Cameron
so
thin
so,
Peter
so impossibility.
So,
well, Cameron.
I love
Man,
that almost every
Cameron.
Mario Kart.
I haven't done much with the British Cameron.
Cameron's been so busy. What country is he in right now?
I think he's back already, but he went to like Lanzarote or something.
Boy, he'd be living his best life.
His name Jeff.
I want to play Street Fighter. I want to teach him Street Fighter 3. It was so much fun, and when he showed interest in fighting games, when I was like a. I was like a child in a candy store with like a gleeful, just teary eyes, like someone finally acknowledged me.
mainly at
Cameron
the moment.
Cameron Senpai noticed me.
Cameron Senpai.
Cameron,
noticed me.
I usually see him playing Overwatch with Dale.
Cool.
Plays video games?
I don't play that game anymore.
I have it for PS4.
They ruined Torb. By making him good.
By making him good.
Wait, what?
I dislike that we're in 100cc right now.
It's kind of slow.
I mean, you don't even build the turret anymore, you just throw it out. It sucks.
Build it up, break it down.
Build him up, break him down.
There you go.
Now you're cooking with magic.
What?
Oh. I don't know where we're referencing, so I just said
I don't think that's a quote.
No, it's not. I just said a thing. I didn't get the reference.
Okay.
I just made sounds with my bodies.
Who had the boo?
Luigi.
I don't have a boo.
Oh, cool. Someone stole my triple shrooms.
Has anyone else picked up Link's Awakening for Switch?
Nope.
No. That costs money. Instead, I spent $60 on Amiibo.
I was gonna buy it And then I was like, well, I am just, like, no-lifing World of Warcraft right now, so why would I pick up another game?
I was like, why am I in first place? I've never made it this far. Year? Wait, why are the other players not racing? I got disconnected.
Oh, God.
No. SpaghettiOs.
It's okay. I
Welcome
haven't been...
Mario Kart.
I'm still racing. I haven't been disconnected. But I'm a little too far forward in first. I'm just going to say. I'm about to...
Are you Baby Ouija?
I'm Baby Ouija, yeah.
You're dead last.
Yeah, you're a bot. What was I gonna say?
You're a
bot.
Yeah.
I haven't bought. Awakening because I spend all my time playing Smash Brothers, and then I spend a little extra of my all time playing other fighting games. I don't have time for these baby games. The Link's Awakening.
Wait, I probably will get it.
It's really fun so far.
I'm thinking about it. I mean, I got
bills to pay. I also played Awakening DX already, so I don't feel this. Just feel as like a million remakes are being made, and it's just hard to be interested in playing the same games over and over.
I got the Link's Awakening amiibo, if that means anything.
No, it means you're a fake fan.
No, it means you like plastic figures.
I mean, I do have 191 of them.
You have the exact same amount as the official Nintendo store in New York City. Whenever I go to New York City, I walk into the Nintendo store, and whoever I'm with, I point at the display behind a glass box that the Nintendo store has, because they're literally the distributors, and I say, my friend Thomas has all of these. And they go, really? And I say, yeah, see that one that has Japanese characters instead of English letters? He has that one too. And they're like, is he from Japan? And I just say, no. And they go, oh, and that's where the conversation ends.
Wow.
What do you expect them to do?
There's 7 Japan exclusives and I have them all.
Wow. All
right.
Yeah.
That's sick.
6 of them are Monster Hunter.
I have almost every single Link amiibo.
I do have every single Link amiibo.
I genuinely just stopped collecting them after, like, the first wave.
I only care about the peach ones, so I can
say that.
That's a little bit easier to collect.
I have this thing called brain damage, and once I pick up one piece of plastic, I have to have them all.
Are you
which
sure
is why
you
I'm
drained?
Really, really upset that a certain someone got me started on Funko Pops.
Are you sure it's brain damage and not drain damage?
You know what? You might be onto something right there.
Just do what I
think your wallet's leaking.
Do what I do and just only collect Funko Pops that you have an intimate connection to. Don't collect series.
That's my plan. Like,
don't collect series.
I'm getting the Pokemon ones because it's Pokemon.
Don't collect series. I don't care. You don't need.
I already have.
You
them.
Don't need the random side character from Attack on Titan 2. Get your waifu. Get your Sakurai, and that's it.
Get your Sakurai.
I don't know the names of the characters. All I know is that one of them's the badass everyone loves, just like Sakurai. All right.
And one of them directed Smash Bros.
I know who Sakurai is. It was the first name I pulled out of my head.
I actually have not watched Attack on Titan in like a good while.
You have?
Yeah, I haven't watched any of season 2.
I've heard that apparently Eren has like become like the best protagonist ever.
In the manga right now, yes.
I think even in the anime too.
He's getting there, but he's even more so in the manga right now.
Don't tell me.
I'm not gonna tell you shit. I mean, it's Attack on Titan. You know, it's plot twist after plot twist. So
yeah. Okay, like you were holding the horn. We're in 10th and 11th place. Did you really have to press the button?
I didn't, but then I was like, wait, don't I recognize that inkling?
Nope.
You're a kid. You're a squid. You're a kid. You're a squid.
I'm also playing the black inkling.
We love diversity here.
I mean, we do.
Bryce says after offensively
I
just
might
saying the first
be repeating
Japanese
myself.
Name that comes to his mind.
I might be repeating myself, but the purple villager skin got changed from a white skinned villager to a black skinned villager before the game released. It was white in the trailer. But Ooh. Then it was a black then it was black skinned in the game.
Wait, which game are we talking about? Cool.
We're talking about
Smash Ultimate.
Yeah.
It was you know the one with the 4 on the shirt?
Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure
purple one? Yeah, it used to be white and now it's black.
Well, in Animal Crossing,
I can't remember, but can you have different skin tone villagers or like protagonists in the actual Animal Crossing game?
I'm pretty sure you can, yeah.
Maybe a New Leaf, but not DSP and GameCube.
I'm not sure about that, but I haven't played any Animal Crossing except Happy the Home Designer. Yes, you can lynch me.
I have
because that is the only one I cared about because you make houses and women love decorating, so they knew their demographic.
Girl,
okay?
Don't even worry about
you
that.
You
want to
know the only
I
one
like
I've played?
Too. Girl, I love a good decoration. Don't even get me started.
You want to know the only Animal Crossing I've played?
Which one?
What?
Pocket Camp?
Sean, you know.
Isabelle and Mario Kart?
I played it with you, Sean.
Happy Amiibo Festival.
Amiibo Festival.
Oh, yes.
I have all four.
I forgot about that.
Animal Crossing games.
I genuinely crossed that out of my memory.
And
I know.
Do you have all the Amiibo cards?
No. No, I don't.
Wait, Thomas.
You
don't have all the Amiibos. If you don't have the Amiibo cards, you don't have all Amiibos.
You're not a real Amiibo collector if you don't have the Amiibo cards. Nintendo Store has the Amiibo cards.
Buy them, Thomas. Buy them, Thomas.
I plan on it. You too.
Don't do you. Everyone, you're such bad friends. Holy shit.
We're just encouraging you.
Waste more money on plastic.
You can buy the complete sets on eBay. I plan on it, but not yet.
I'm planning on buying another Switch plastic, but so that I can have another set, another tournament set up for Smash Brothers. So like, you're spending like about the same amount of money, I imagine.
Get a Switch Lite. That way you can have the collector and you can.
Oh yeah,
a
Switch Lite for a tournament setup. That's a good idea.
I support it.
I have the Shadow Mewtwo card.
I have that one. I stole it.
What?
What? What?
Okay, so story time.
FBI, open up.
So story time.
I'm listening.
Here in North America, the like go-to game franchise store is called GameStop, or in Canada, EB Games. I used to work.
You said here
hi,
in
welcome
North
to EB
America.
Games.
Exactly.
Welcome to EB Games.
I used to work at EB Games, and I would say that. Hi, welcome to EB Games. And when I was working there, So here's the thing. When I was working there, the Wii U was like just being phased out. I was the very first person at our store to pre-order a Switch because I worked the day pre-orders released. So I pre-ordered the Switch. I pre-ordered Master Edition of Breath of the Wild. Your boy made sure he took advantage of his privilege there.
Yeah, I'm so jealous of not being able to get the Master Edition.
Oh, I love my Master Edition. My sword sits on my desk.
Oh yeah, dude, I got it too.
Anyways, so
you boys and your swords.
So when people trade
boys
in,
generally have swords.
When people trade in used games, we have to take the discs out and put them in like a filing system so that when the cases are on the floor, people don't just steal the games. They have to bring the case forward, they have to pay and go through the transaction in order to get the disc for the game they want to buy.
I know where this is going.
Yes, yes.
When people traded in Pokken Tournament for Wii U, we were only told to grab the disc, grab nothing else from inside the case. And so I said to my manager, I was like, but hold on, that means we're leaving the Amiibo cards inside of these cases and people can just steal them. And my manager's response was, not our problem. So I went, okay, not our problem. And I just took one of the cards.
Oh.
I mean, fair.
Yeah,
fair.
I had planned to get Pokken Tournament for Wii U before it was announced for the Switch. I still plan on getting it, but now I want to get on the Switch. And I was like, I want to make sure that the copy I buy I want to make sure that I get the Mewtwo card, even if the copy I buy doesn't have it.
Mm-hmm.
So now we're safe.
Pokken is like one of the best fighting games ever made, but no one plays it and no one takes it seriously, which sucks because it's a really good fighting game.
Okay, so I don't know what defines a good fighting game. What can you explain?
Yeah, what does makes define a good fighting game?
Define a good... Well, first
Tell
of all, it has
girl.
To be fun. It has to be fun, first of all.
Okay,
That's the primary thing. If you're playing something that's not fun, then don't play it.
But what's wrong with you?
Second of all is you need to have you don't even need to have a balanced cast of characters, but you need to make sure that there's a relatively healthy diversity of good characters. Like, if half the roster, like, of 25 characters are viable for competitive play, then it's a fairly good and balanced game.
Right, right. Rather than just having, like, a select few that everyone always goes
yeah,
for.
Yeah, like, how
Smash
and Eisheimer were, right. were Brawl, and Bayonetta and Cloud were Smash 4. Like, having a top tier that is that strong to the point where some scenes are planning on banning the character, that's unhealthy. Second of all, the game needs to encourage interaction. A lot of fighting games have a problem where passive campy play is rewarded over aggression and, like, interacting with your opponent. Obviously, oh, okay. like, it's kind of the same problem that some card games have. I'm not sure if you know the term floodgate.
No.
Where it's basically a card. It's basically meant to just stop your opponent from being able to play the game. Characters that completely stop other characters from playing the game are not fun or healthy or good for the game.
Right,
and it
right.
also makes, like, the tournament it makes it a bad spectator sport as well.
Yeah, yeah. Because there's not enough happening.
Yeah, like, not the thing is, nothing is happening most of the time. And that is very boring to watch, and there's no new... Even in, like, some campy games, there's some nuance, like, how well you space and, like, how if you make mistakes and whatnot. That can be very exhilarating, seeing how well a player is able to manipulate the game.
Sean, mm-hmm. get the fuck over here.
What?
And then,
I tried
then,
to
like,
hit the boomerang, like, three times.
A third factor is that the game needs to look good, because you're going to be staring at it for thousands of hours.
Yeah, and so do you think that, like, out of everything you've said so far, do you think that Pokken Tournament hit most of those boxes?
Yeah, I think it did. The game looks a bit weird for a Pokemon game, but it doesn't look bad.
Yeah.
It runs relatively well. It's 60 frames per second, even if it's not 1080p. It's got fun, simple, easy to play, hard to master mechanics.
Okay.
There's a lot of your investment gets rewarded, which is important, obviously, for a competitive game, is that the more time you put in, the more you get out of it.
Yeah.
And then, what else? Well, I don't really know about the balance. It feels like a lot of the... It feels like the cast is pretty balanced, though. Like, every character, just because the base system of the game, kind of like how in Tekken, like, some characters are obviously much better than others, but the base system of how the game is built makes it so that even characters with mostly bad moves can still win.
Right, right. So, like, most of the stuff you've explained was kind of, like, one of the reasons why I actually, you know, loved Rocket League. I'm using past tense. Still do, but I don't play it as much anymore.
Sean doesn't play Rocket League as much anymore.
Hey, man, when you put as much hours into something, even I will stop at some point.
Yeah, you get tired after a while.
5,000 hours.
But, like, it was because, like, the thing I always had trouble with fighting games was that, like, you were making the argument that, like, it's as long as you have, like, a good amount of characters who are viable, then it's good. But, like, it's the reason, like, the game was that everything was standardized to the point that the only separation really was skill.
Like, yeah. Anymore. I mean, there is something to be said about that as well. Like, older fighting games have balance that is completely out the window, but the system mechanics and the character that, the few, like, two or three characters that are top tier are really fun to watch and really fun to play. So it kind of circumvents the problem, but generally you want a healthy amount of characters in the meta.
Mm-hmm.
Because it also, like, makes, it also might, like, change some power dynamics, like, maybe a discovery comes out that makes a character that was weaker before, suddenly, like, a much bigger threat in the meta, and that's always exciting.
Yeah.
And, so, yeah. But in general, okay. like, the balance is actually not as important as people make it out to be. Just as long as what is the top tier isn't completely broken and, like, it's actually fun to play.
So
the problem with Bayonetta was that, like, no one could counterplay her. Once you got hit, you died. There was no interaction.
Right. So she just literally shit-stomped everyone.
Yeah, it's also with Meta Knight, because he had 5 jumps and 4 recovery specials. It was ridiculous how he could outcamp the entire cast and nobody could do anything about it, to the point where they had to invent a ledge grab limit just to keep Meta Knight in check.
Wow.
So, like, there are bad decks. Like, that was just to, like, stop a toxic playstyle, and he was still the best character in the game by a long shot.
Put Meta Knight in the corner. Go think about what you've done, Meta Knight.
Don't put baby in the corner. So what's
but
everyone's...
He's still kind of okay.
What's everyone's favorite genre? Emma, I'm assuming yours is fighting?
Yeah, fighting games, or I guess tournament fighters is a more common term. Because, like, obviously, like, Devil May Cry is a fighting game, but it's not in the same category.
Oh, I actually don't know what my favorite genre is. Like, I don't think I have... Well, like,
Monster Hunter is the genre.
Exploration, maybe?
No, it's like, to be honest with you, like, I have a lot of games I love, and almost all of them are in different genres.
Yeah, same.
So I don't think I have a favorite genre.
Thomas, I would assume your favorite genre would be platformers.
See, mine's a toss-up between platformers and whatever you count Smash as.
It's called a platform fighter.
Platform fighter, yeah.
So even then, a platform is involved in the name.
Yeah, so I'd say platform fighters are my favorite, with just regular platformers as a secondary.
Sure.
Do you play Rivals of Aether at all?
Huh?
Do you play Rivals of Aether?
I haven't, but I wanna try it.
Have you played Brawlhalla? That one's a fun one.
Yeah,
I've heard
about
that.
I think I have.
I didn't really care for it, but it was fun.
I played it a lot on computer back in high school. They just released a copy of it for the Switch, free as well. I recommend it. It's pretty fun.
I think I actually downloaded that.
If I take a long hard think about it, I guess really just as long as it's got multiplayer in it. But then again, like, I love Metroid, so that's single player.
Liberation Force.
My favorite category
is
good games.
Hey, that's the only one I didn't play, so I guess that's a counter-argument.
That's also my favorite category. Good games is a good category.
Good games.
Yep.
I think mine would have...
One more race?
It's sad. Yeah, let's do one more race. Okay. Yeah. It's sad that this is my favorite genre, because I never have time to play any of them, but definitely role-playing games.
I
love
say, you seem like
role-playing
RPG
games,
guy.
But I never have the time to invest in them, which sucks.
See, like, if I was to list out a few games that I've played that, like... all fall into different genres. Rocket League, World of Warcraft, Mario Kart, every Metroid game except Federation Force.
That's funny, because the first three you listed were all multiplayer, and then you list Metroid, but not the multiplayer Metroid. Yeah.
What about Metroid Pinball? Metroid Pinball, anybody?
I actually never did get around to doing that, actually.
Metroid
you gotta
Pinball.
Get back to Let's Play in the Prime series, you gotta do the pinball one.
Fuck.
It's called Metroid Prime Pinball.
Yeah.
That'd be a prime series to watch.
Oh!
Can we briefly mention the fact that Sean waited so long to get a new Metroid Prime announced, and then they delay it.
Okay. So, for my opinion on that, it's basically, I heard that they were handing the development over to Retro Studios, and I know everyone was super happy about that. I know everyone was delighted about that. However, I learned that almost everyone from Retro Studios who worked on the Prime series is no longer working there.
Oh my god.
So, I mean, it's going to be good because they're going to have a lot of assets that they can use. I'd imagine they're just going to reuse a bunch of them, or, like, you know, at least to an extent.
The old ones.
Yeah,
imagine, like, they carry a bit of a name, so, like, it's not gonna be, like, no-name garbage developers that are
Yeah,
there.
Exactly. But, if I take a second to think about it, like, what I'm most excited to know is how they're gonna implement, the same motion controls, for the Prime series that they did with the Wii. Because I know the sensors on, the Switch are, like, way better. I just don't know how it's going to be implemented, because the other one had, like, a very exact, like, you know, sensor. I don't know how the Switch works.
The Switch, it does have a pointer feature. I don't quite know how they do it.
Yeah.
It's called, like, an AR or something like that. It's the same kind of thing that a television remote would use.
Okay.
Oh, infrared?
Infrared. It has an infrared sensor.
right. as an infrared sensor, but then also has there is some sort of camera
no.
built into the Joy-Con.
True.
I can, yeah. I got a communication error,
right
guys.
One.
Oh, in the last race.
Oh, that sucks.
oh well, I mean that kind of works out a little bit.
Yeah, we got that's fine. I mean, this kind of turns into a podcast like halfway through.
It's great, like the dynamic between the three series. Like Smash is just it's Smash. You talk about what the hell's going on. Mario Kart, everyone just kind of zones out and talks about whatever.
I mean, it's
and then Splatoon's just kind of a lot of screaming.
Splatoon? Yes.
Yeah, Splatoon's like get the
as an
get
as,
the
as a reoccurring Splatoon cast member, I support that claim.
I also support the eradication of all fly fishes.
True.
Death of all fly fish.
Sign a petition.
Are we terraforming today, or are we fly fishing?
I think what you mean is, what did we do 2 days ago, Bryce?
What?
The answer to that question.
Splatter Days comes out before Mario Kart. We don't need everyone to know that we're recording it after Mario Kart.
Oh my god, what? No, I meant in the special Splatoon DLC map that we race on in Mario Kart is what I was talking about.
Yeah, you know, salmon course.
No, I already know what we did or are going to do for Splatoon in 2 days before
Oink.
Now, 2 days after now
Oink.
Time.
Salmon run.
I just kind of zoned out for like 10 seconds there, and I'm not really sure where I am anymore.
Perfect, I hope the audience zoned out with you.
I'm just not sure where I am anymore.
Also, like now that I'm here, Alexander Jordan Smith, if you're
right
there, knock knock, hello.
Hey, what's up?
Knock knock, there. It's Knuckles.
Alexander Jordan Smith is there. Hey, buddy.
Hello.
It's your boy.
Alexander Jordan Smith. Everyone say hello to Alexander Jordan Smith.
Alexander
Hi.
Jordan,
hello.
Please get out of my house.
Are we leaving? Are we leaving the map? Are we done?
Yeah, we're done.
Yeah.
We are finished.
I think we're done.
No, I wanted to go back. I didn't want to pick a race.
I had something else I was going to say, and I completely forgot what it was. Yay.
What you wanted to say was, thank you all so much for tuning in to another episode of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Worldwide.
We going back to Sean singing the end.
All right, Sean, it's time you sing the end slate. Say goodbye to everyone and sing us out. Wait. The end card. What song do you have playing for your end card,
Thomas? It's like the end of my intro theme.
Do you know the end of his intro?
Nope.
No, that's
nope.
The Jaltron theme.
And let
that's
that be
the
a
Jaltron
theme.
Wait, I'm gonna move the Mario Kart music away from my ears.
Well, okay, that's like the intro.
Wait, that's wrong. That's really wrong.
Yeah.
This bit, we're carrying this bit on a little too long. We need that
just a little bit. Yeah, I think the end slate might have even been playing over all this.